नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, वी एट NYN नॉलेज सेंटर वेलकम यू इन द वीडियो शो ऑफ मैथ एंड ग्राइंडिंग पार्ट टू। एज यू हैव सीन इन पार्ट वन ऑफ द सेम टॉपिक, वी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू जनरेट कर्व्ड सरफेस इन द बोर ऑफ वर्क पीस यूजिंग सिलिंड्रिकल शेप ग्राइंडिंग व्हील। एंड नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी डिस्कस how curvature can be generated on external surfaces of workpiece with the help of cylindrical grinding wheel or cup shaped grinding wheel. Before starting this video, requesting subscribe to this channel in order to receive information about future coming video. Let us start. As shown in figure 1, D is grinding wheel diameter and R is radius of grinding wheel, means D by 2. Now, when grinding wheel axis is parallel to workpiece, then it can generate radius equal to R, that is radius of grinding wheel. Second, when grinding wheel axis perpendicular to workpiece plane, it generates straight surface or R equal to infinite. It means if we grind any surface using this method, radius achieved will be between R, that is half of the diameter of grinding wheel, to infinite. Achieved ground surface width will be less than diameter of grinding wheel. To make this concept useful, we formulate the parameters involved in it. Now, let us see figure 2. Here, A is angle between grinding wheel face and workpiece plane where grinding to be carried out. L is the length of face of grinding wheel that take part in the grinding. C is depth of ground surface. Then C is equal to L sine A. That is the first equation. And angle A will be sine inverse C by L. This is the second equation. Another relation we got is L is equal to small r minus under root small r square minus a square. Here a is half of the width of the ground surface. Now in figure 3, capital R is equal to radius of ground surface, h is perpendicular distance as shown in the figure, a is half of the width of ground surface as explained earlier. Then h square equal to whole square of capital R minus C, and a square equal to capital R square minus h square. Substituting the value of h in this equation, we have a square is equal to capital R square minus whole square of capital R minus C. Solving this equation, we get R is equal to A square plus C square whole upon 2C, the third equation. Using this equation, we can calculate the radius of ground surface. Now we got formula to calculate grinding wheel tilt angle, achieve radius during grinding on workpiece, ground surface depth and width, etc. To perform this operation, instead of cylindrical shape grinding wheel, cup shaped wheel can be used. In fact, this is more suitable to avoid operational errors. This method can be used to generate first straight curved surface grinding on flat workpiece, second curved surface grinding of cylindrical workpiece by rotating workpiece. on its axis. Third, dislike spherical shape by rotating workpiece on its axis. Remember, when workpiece is rotating on its axis, curvature can be generated on its one end, means perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece. I hope you will find this video useful. In case you want to use this and in use you find any difficulty, feel free to contact. Once again, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you.